No difference than a woman not being allowed to wear pants, which is a man's thing. Women wear dresses, women wear skirts. Where do we get that? That's our culture in America. That's the way we think, but that's not biblically sound. That has nothing to do with scripture. That has to do with the times that the scripture was written in. That's how they dress. That was a part of their laws and their culture. Okay, but our culture has allowed it. The same with the Old Testament scripture stating that a woman should not preach. Well, in our culture, a woman is allowed to preach, but the scripture says something different. So that's a whole nother topic of discussion about women preaching in the church, because the scriptures I read, they were not in a sarcastic manner that Paul was writing. That was a part of the law. However, we know that God would use a rock to deliver his word. He would use a donkey. He would use whatever has breath. So I'm not going to debate about if a woman should be a preacher or a leader in the church. That's not the point. The point is, what does God say about it, and what is the culture says about it? But we're dealing with earrings right now. Okay, we have to keep in perspective the time and the origin of the laws and the commandments. I live in America, and in our culture and our society is running very differently than in biblical times. Either we are under the law or we're not. The Bible says if you break one law, you break them all. But I have not found in scripture that a man wearing an earring, is it a sin, or is even if it or does it offend God? I haven't seen that yet. I have not seen that scripture. You have the Levitical law, the first covenant, then now we are under grace. Christ did not come to destroy the law, but to fulfill it, Matthew 5:17. But men not wearing an earring was never a law or commandment to be broken. It is a preference for each pastor, and pastors and leaders should get a better understanding of the scriptures before passing it off as their own character, beliefs, and practices as scripture. So all that really means is, let's say I'm a pastor and I don't like men sagging. Okay, sagging in church. That's another issue. Is that in scripture? No. Not sagging is not in scripture. You're not going to find verses say, hey, if your pants are sagging, don't do that. They probably didn't even have pants back then. Okay? So you're not going to find it in scripture. But what does the sagging of the pants represent? Is it more important to look at the origin? The origin of pants sagging, with the history I looked up a long time ago, it had to do with also identifying as gay in the jails, because they took away their belts. So the belt, their pants would sag in a sense. So that way people knew and identified who the gays were. I heard the saying with the earring, that if a person had an earring, they are identifying themselves with the homosexual culture. But that has nothing to do with the scripture. That has nothing to do with what's written in the scripture. So if I'm that pastor and I don't like people to sag, I could say, obey the rule, you know, obey those who have the rule over you. And then there is no debate. There is no topic of discussion. You could say that for every topic, but show me in scripture. Don't show me a sign. I'm saying show me in God's word. Okay, so you would say it's a bad representation of a Christian. This could be true or false, but what is a good representation of a Christian, is it a suit and tie? Is it a shirt and tie? Is it slacks? What is it? Because from what I see, you can have crooked, evil men in a suit and tie. So you can't say that just because it's packaged properly, that that makes it more spiritual connected, okay? So wearing an earring is no more sin than sagging of the pants, if you look at it in that perspective, which I wasn't really trying to relate the two. But we know that worldly people, right? Worldly people have big old earrings, diamonds to show off. To show off. The last time I checked, I don't wear earrings to show off to the world. What about pants sagging? That is a gang related type of situation. Anytime you see somebody sagging, they kind of trying to say, hey, I'm from the street, I'm from the hood, I represent this, I represent that. They're not really trying to come with a professional demeanor. But what does professional demeanor or professional look has to do with spirituality? The Bible says, come as you are. Not stay that way, but come as you are. A lot of pastors are turning away people because of their traditional teachings. And the traditions are passed on to say, well, if you're sagging, then that's wrong. It may be your preference that you don't like it, but you can't show me in scripture where it's wrong. Wearing an earring is wrong, but you can't show me in scripture that wearing an earring is wrong. So don't pass it off as scripture is my only point. I'm not trying to say that I speak eloquently. I'm not even saying that I am very good with speech. But what I'm trying to relate to you is that if a pastor has something passionate within their heart, don't try to use the scripture to deliver your personal message.